So, we have just had the announcement of the brand new MacBook Pros with the M1 Pro and the M1 Max chipset. So today I've decided to do a comparison for you guys of the M1 Max 16-inch MacBook Pro versus the MacBook Pro 16-inch Intel i9 older MacBook Pro. And today I want to do a specs review for you. Hi guys, it's Matt here. So that's right, today I want to do a comparison of the brand new MacBook Pro 16-inch with the M1 Max chipset inside it, the fully loaded one, versus the older Intel i9 MacBook Pro 16-inch. And I want to do a specs review, a comparison of both of these models. Well, let's get started. So remember guys, this is a comparison between the MacBook Pro 16-inch, the M1 Max, not the M1 Pro. I will be making another video for the M1 Pro very shortly, so do check that out on my channel when it comes up. But this will be the M1 Max 16-inch MacBook Pro versus the MacBook Pro 16-inch Intel i9. And this is the model that came out 2 years ago, and it's the last Intel MacBook Pro 16-inch. So let's start then with the display type. So both these have great displays. So the MacBook Pro Intel i9 model has an LED IPS technology screen, whereas the brand new MacBook Pro with the M1 Max inside it has a mini LED ProMotion display. And this basically means it's much more brighter, it's much more clear in its contrast, and also at the same time, it's also a ProMotion display. So it means it's got a 120Hz refresh rate, and also it's got adaptive screen as well, so it can go right down to 10Hz and go all the way back up to 120Hz. And Apple call this an XDR Retina display. For the actual screen size, basically they're almost identical. The MacBook Pro Intel version had a 16-inch basically dead on, whereas the MacBook Pro 16-inch now with the M1 Max has a 16.2-inch display, so it's ever so slightly larger. Then for screen resolution, the MacBook Pro with the M1 Max has a resolution of 3,456 by 2,234, whereas the normal 16-inch MacBook Pro with the Intel i9 has a 3,072 by 1,920. So you can see a boost up here in pixels. And talk about a boost up in pixels, you can definitely see this in the pixels per inch or the PPI. Whereas the MacBook Pro with the M1 Max has a 254 pixels per inch, whereas the old Intel i9 version only has 226 pixels per inch. Moving on to the display refresh rate, and I've already spoke about this a little bit already. The original Intel i9 version had a 60Hz refresh rate, and to be honest, all MacBook Pros before this had a 60Hz refresh rate, whereas now the brand new M1 Max has a 120Hz ProMotion XDR Retina display now. So that's really, really good. It's double the amount of the refresh rate, or can go up to double the amount. For brightness and true tone, the new MacBook Pro with the M1 Max has a 1000 nits as its standard brightness. It can go slightly brighter than this, but for its standard display brightness, it's 1000 nits, whereas the original MacBook Pro with the Intel i9 only has a 500 nits. Both of these screens have that true tone technology as well built into them. Moving onwards then, we do have the actual processors, and this is where things change quite a lot. So now we have the option for the MacBook Pro 16-inch. We have a choice between M1 Pro and also the M1 Max. And like I said, I'm talking about the M1 Max here today, but it's nice to know you've got those two choices. Both of those have the choice of a 10-core CPU, and that's 2 efficiency cores, 8 performance cores. And also with the actual graphics as well, you can actually go up to a 32 core GPU, but you can also pick a 24 GPU in the M1 Max. Then for the MacBook Pro 16-inch with the Intel i9, and there is a choice that you can pick an i7, but with the Intel i9, it was only an 8-core CPU, and they were basically the same cores all along it. And basically, you also had a dedicated AMD Radeon graphics card that ranged basically from a 5500 with the Intel i9 configuration, but you could also pick an AMD Radeon 5600 as well as a dedicated graphics card inside the MacBook.
MacBook Pro. So straight away, there are some big differences here. It's been claimed that the M1 Max with the 32-core GPU is basically double the amount of speed and power what you got with their AMD 5600, what was inside the Intel i9, the maximum configuration. So moving on to a Geekbench 5 multi-core score for both of these MacBook Pros. So starting with the Intel i9 actually had a score of 6870 for its multi-core score. And to be honest, this was a little less than the original M1 chipset. But for the M1 Max with that 10-core CPU, we now get a multi-core score of 11542. This is actually even higher than the lowest spec Mac Pro desktop and is close to the second lowest Mac Pro desktop you can pick out there with a Xeon chipset inside it. So this is absolutely phenomenal for an actual multi-core score. For RAM, for the M1 Max, not the M1 Pro, just the M1 Max, you can choose between 32GB and 64GB. And then with the MacBook Pro, with the Intel i9, you had a choice of 16GB all the way up to 64GB of RAM. Moving on then to storage, both of these MacBooks had exactly the same storage configurations in choices of the amount of storage that you want. So this is from 512GB all the way up to 8TB on both of these models. For ports, this is where things change quite a bit here. So with the brand new MacBook Pro M1 Max, you now have 3x USB-C ports, and these are Thunderbolt 4s and USB 4 ports. You've also got the return of MagSafe for charging, you've got a HDMI 2.0 port, and you've also got an SDXE card slot as well to put in your SD card. But with the old MacBook Pro with the Intel i9, you only had 4x USB-C ports, and you had to use these ports for charging, and you also had to buy dongles and things to plug other bits and pieces into your MacBook Pro.
So just quickly, guys, as we're going through the specs review, this channel has just got over 260,000 subscribers. What is absolutely amazing. So on this channel right now, I'm doing a giveaway, and it is for this. It is for an iPhone 13 Pro Max in Sierra Blue and 128GB of storage inside. And I'm going to be giving this away to one lucky subscriber when we get over 300,000 subscribers. And all I want to know in the comments below with your chance to win this iPhone 13 Pro Max in this international giveaway is put in the comments of what Apple gear you're planning to buy in the next year. Write it down in the comments below. And also at the same time, if you're new here, make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell, because when we get over 300,000 subscribers, and only when we get over 300,000 subscribers, I'll be announcing who the winner is of this iPhone 13 Pro Max. Now, just a quick note I just want to add here, there might be some scammers out there who say you may have won a prize and to WhatsApp you. This is not me. As I said, when we get over 300,000 subscribers, that is when I'll be announcing who the winner is. Also at the same time, guys, if you're liking this video so far, please do press the like button. Right, let's go back to those specs reviews.
For operating system wise, both of these MacBook Pros will be able to support the same operating system, and that is macOS Monterey. But basically, it's most likely the MacBook Pro M1 Max will probably get an extra one or two operating systems in its lifespan. But don't worry, the MacBook Pro Intel i9 is definitely going to get quite a few more macOS updates in its time. Then moving on to battery life, and then this is where there's some huge changes here. So I'm going to start with the MacBook Pro with the Intel i9. It gave us up to 11 hours of battery life, but the brand new MacBook Pro 16 inch with the M1 Max gives us 21 hours. That is basically almost double the amount what we got in the Intel i9, and that is absolutely phenomenal. Then for charging wattage, the MacBook Pro M1 Max has a 140-watt charger with that MagSafe connection, whereas the Intel i9 MacBook Pro has a USB-C with a 96-watt charger. For weight, the MacBook Pro with the M1 Max is a little bit more heavier at 2.2 kilograms, but the MacBook Pro with the Intel i9 only weighs 2 kilograms. So to be honest, it's not that much difference between them. Then for actual stereo speakers, the MacBook Pro 16-inch M1 Max has stereo speakers but also has spatial audio, whereas the MacBook Pro just basically has the stereo speakers but doesn't have the ability to use spatial audio inside it. Moving on for the Bluetooth, both of these devices have Bluetooth 5.0, so no changes there. But then for webcam, basically the MacBook Pro 16-inch with the M1 Max has a brand new 1080p camera inside it, and this is hidden inside the notch at the top, whether you love it or you hate it. But the MacBook Pro 16-inch Intel i9 also has a webcam, but this is only a 720p, and this is hidden in the border at the top. For price-wise then, so I'm going to do actual comparison first of all of the MacBook Pro 16-inch with an M1 Pro inside it. So this is not the Max. And this starts at $2,499, whereas the MacBook Pro with the 16-inch, and it had an Intel i7 at the time, started at $2,399. And both these models came with a 512GB configuration. So you can see here it's only $100 more. But now, if we pick the M1 Max instead in the 16-inch MacBook Pro, the price starts at $3,499, and this gives you the 1TB as the base model. In comparison, the MacBook Pro 16-inch with an Intel i9, this was the more higher spec one, this started at $3,399, so $100 less than the MacBook Pro with the M1 Max inside it, and this also gave you 1TB of storage. Moving on to colour options, both of these MacBook Pros have had the exact same colour options, so silver and space grey. So, will you be buying yourself a brand new MacBook Pro?
Well, there you have it, guys. You can see that the M1 Max in that 16-inch MacBook Pro completely blows away the specs of the Intel 16-inch with an i9 chipset inside it. It's absolutely incredible. Well, guys, it's also time to wrap up this video. So if you have enjoyed watching it, please do press the like button. And also at the same time as well, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons like this one, please also do hit subscribe, followed by that notification bell. Until next time, guys, I'll see you really soon. Bye bye.